Alright, so HYPERSCAPE is Ubisoft's brand new battle royale, set to contend with things like Warzone, PUBG, where's that been, and of course Apex Legends. But it brings a totally new twist, with sci-fi elements, a futuristic world that decays as you walk through it, as well as a brand new slew of weapons, the idea of upgrading your weapons throughout the game, and a nice blend of casual entry friendliness, but also super high skill cap for those players who dive a little deeper. I mean, I'm talking yoga teacher in bed mobility, so there's some crazy opportunities here, trust me. Listen, I don't want to get off track. The whole point is that you want to play this game. You want to see the gameplay. You want to know what to do when you jump into a game of HYPERSCAPE. How to get better, how to win more games, obviously how to get kills, and how to understand the landscape of how to dominate when you first hop in. And that's what this video is going to do. Throughout this video, I'm going to give you 10 crucial tips on how to instantly improve. So by the second you're done watching this video, you will absolutely be more prepared and be a better HYPERSCAPE player, even if you haven't played the game yet. So let's get into it. The first way to improve in HYPERSCAPE is to understand this is a game about mobility, and it's crazy. It is honestly some of the best mobility and the wildest opportunities to move that I've seen in a battle royale to date, including Apex Legends. Whereas most fighting takes place on the ground in games like Warzone or PUBG, even in Apex you're usually fighting on a solid surface or on the top of a building. In HYPERSCAPE you are fighting mid-air a lot. You are moving, you are double jumping, you are double jumping into a ball mechanic, which we'll get into in a second. But as you guys can see in the gameplay footage, as well as what I'm describing to you here, movement and mobility is key to the HYPERSCAPE experience. High ground is extremely important in this game because it gives you a vantage point over the entire city as it decays, and also the people fighting underneath you and in the buildings. However, don't just stand on the top of the roofs, back down under the slant so that you can see, peek out, and then peek back in with some cover. Also, be aware that you're often shooting down, so having a weapon that gives you the ability to not only trace people while they're up in the air, but sometimes splash damage them while you're above them is crucial to making sure you're prepared for every single engagement. There are huge central towers that have a jet stream that can carry you up to the top so you can overlook the entire city and reposition from there, and there are bounce pads all across the map as well. So if you don't understand that mobility is key, hopefully you do now. Get used to it. My suggestion is to practice. Try just spending a few games using your mobility as part of the focus, not your shooting, just understanding how to move and be tricky around the map, because that will save you 9 times out of 10. If you are better at moving than someone else, you will probably win that fight against them. Number 2, level ups. Now when you're jumping into the game, you're going to see a bunch of guns and different types of opportunities for you to get hacks or weapons. These weapons and hacks, as we'll get into in 4 and 5 of the tips, are really crucial to the game, but they don't just come in their standard form. If you keep picking up the standard form of each of these weapons, you will continue to upgrade them and get special perks after each upgrade. They're actually called fusions, so I probably should have called this fusions instead of level ups, but it is crucial to actually having a gun that late game allows you to be successful in your duels. Now, if you hadn't watched this video, you might have been a noob like me in my first couple of games where I would just pick one weapon, one hack, and then move on. But actually, you have to keep finding those weapons, and it makes it fun. It actually is a little mini game that you'll honestly really enjoy if you're a loot goblin like me, but also can help involve your teammates into making sure everyone's geared out. If you're running an assault rifle and maybe a salvo like a grenade launcher, make sure you tell your teammates. They can ping it for you, and then you can go pick up those across the map so that you can get your fused weapon faster. Is that really important, Rain Day? Do fused weapons make that much of a difference? Of course they do, you dummy. Seriously, fused weapons are the bomb. They give you more magazine size, they give you more damage per bullet, they basically give your weapons everything you need to be more successful to win a duel, and they hit harder. So if you're trying to get a sniper rifle to go against a level 5 fully fused sniper rifle, you're just not going to win that battle unless you are like God reinvented as a gamer in 2020, which I just can't see happening with the way 2020 is going. Oh God. Oh God, that got dark. Number 3, viewer interaction. A quick side note to this is that viewer interaction actually is a huge part of HYPERSCAPE, and it's a big tip to understand because it will change the way that the matches go. There are Twitch extensions that are actually being built to integrate within HYPERSCAPE, so viewers who are watching you play, like you guys can watch me on twitch.tv/rainday right now as this video is live playing some HYPERSCAPE, can literally earn battle pass points, can actually earn the ability to match up with me and be picked up in my squad to play, but also you guys can change what's happening in the game. From things like everyone gets extra healing to everyone has anti-gravity. If you remember the Darwin Project, it was a game that kind of was exclusively tied to Mixer and their interactions with their viewership. It's very similar, but on Twitch, and I think it comes across really nicely in this game. Stuff like anti-grav doesn't really feel oppressive, but it does mean that if the viewers decide to do it, you can't really jump unless you want to be super exposed and just hanging in the air without that mobility that's so crucial to avoid fights. It makes you play differently, and it feels like there's a nice fusion of interaction between creator and the content that people are viewing, but also helping to create. So if you don't know that's coming, you will probably die to a few of them. I have done the same myself. Just be aware, viewer interaction will change your gameplay throughout some of the matches. Number four, hacks. Now, a hack is technically an ability. That's kind of what I like to call it, and you can find them throughout the map. In this gameplay technical test that you're going to see for HYPERSCAPE with all the videos coming out right now, there are currently 9 hacks and 9 weapons in the game, and the hacks come in all different shapes and sizes. There's a hack for healing, because you have to auto-generate heals, because if you get bursted down, there's no armor in this game, you have to wait to get out of a fight and come back with full health, or you will just die. Secondly, you can find things like invisibility. So if you're in the middle of a fight or someone's trying to chase you, you could pop in your invisibility, hide out in a sneaky spot, maybe even just stand still, and then hopefully get away scot-free. But there's also things like slam, which offer more mobility and allow you to jump up into the air and slam down with a huge burst of power, knocking enemies up and doing damage. But one of my favorite ones are things like teleport and ball, which allow you to obviously teleport in a distance, and a ball, which turns you into a huge bouncing ball that can't take too much damage, but gets incredible amounts of height initially and allows you to stay in it as long as you want or until it is destroyed. The hacks play a huge part of how you want to operate and play your game, whether you're picking up armor and healing, or maybe you're picking up invisibility and teleport so you can be sneaky and get away safely and kind of hold until your teammate is with you in a fight. All of these things help to build your playstyle, and just like weapons, you can fuse them again and again so that they reduce their cooldown, they become more powerful, more distance, and they become essentially more effective abilities so that late game you are able to outtrade and out-hack your opponents. Personally, my favorite hacks that you'll probably see some of are ball, which I found was just really good at getting high ground, at relocating, and just allowing a bit of a diversion to get away and create space and time. But also, I liked teleport quite a bit. I went hyper mobility because this game really allows you to take advantage of it with smart decision making, and I found that to work for me. But I saw someone really operating well with armor and as well as invisibility. So you have to find your combo that works best and use it to your benefit. Number five, weapons. Now, as I mentioned, there are 9 weapons in the game, and I honestly want to talk a little bit more about what to do with them and which ones I found were kind of meta at the start, because that might change, but I think on launch you should be using these certain weapons, and we'll go into a full breakdown in another video. The weapons have a nice variety, from assault rifle to sniper to huge random explosion that's like a sonic burst knocking people up, you know, the ultimate weapon that you'd find in like Turok Evolutions or something on N64. There's a lot of variety, and it actually made it really fun for me. But one of the things I loved about it is the fusion aspect of all of these weapons. So from a shotgun or a pistol, if you fuse your weapons enough, you will be able to do some serious damage in the situation that they're supposed to be effective. For me, the Ripper, the assault rifle, was a really good pickup that I started to like towards the late game of my playtest time. I also found people turning the Hexfire into the meta weapon. It did so much damage. It's essentially a huge machine gun that has almost an infinite amount of ammo and really is dangerous if you're floating up or trying to use that high ground and that mobility to get away and escape. It can punish people who are too exposed. I also really like having a splash damage weapon, so something like a Komodo, which was pretty beginner friendly, but also very useful at kind of knocking people up and around, doing some nice burst damage when you couldn't quite get that easy line of sight and they maybe made it around a corner. I also thought the Salvo was a very good grenade launcher, and that ended up being pretty meta, and I saw some people do some serious work with it on me. Also, if you guys want to have some cool clips and maybe explode a group of enemies, the Skybreaker is a really fun, hard to use, but very, very big reward, kind of a Turok Evolutions weapon, I'd say. It essentially shoots this huge ball of electricity and knocks people up, does a ton of damage, and it's just really, really fun AoE to use. So overall, my impression was that the weapons were versatile, you could pretty much use any weapon if you leveled it up enough, and that honestly, they were very, very fun. I just think consider bringing a balance of hit scan as well as this kind of AoE blast to make sure you're covered on all bases. Number six, looting. Now, looting may seem pretty simple at first, but you're gonna have to take a second just to figure out what it means for your keybinds. I think the first couple of games, I was really more focused on how do I loot and pick things up, considering I'm coming from Apex Legends as my main battle royale. However, one of the things that I thought was kind of funny that I just never was told, and you might not be told either, is to break through the orange doors when you are on the map. That's actually not a closed building, it's just an entrance into a building that is currently closed unless you melee it. And it ultimately gives you the opportunity to know that if the doors aren't broken, no one's been in there, there's still loot on the staircases, and you can go ahead and try to grab your weapons. All right, number 7, how to manage a fight. Well, this is an important one. I mean, fights in this game are pretty long, and I could say even longer than Apex Legends. Definitely if you're coming from Warzone or from PUBG or from a different shooting experience with maybe a lower time to kill, this is going to be a game that's going to take some time for you to actually master, because your fights aren't going to be ending after you jump out in a corner and then spray somebody down in 0.5 seconds. They're going to keep going. That guy's going to jump around the corner again. He's going to jump into the air, turn into a wall, teleport halfway across the map, and you're going to have to chase him. And so playing these fights is less about checkers, the quick and easy solution and easy opportunity gain and loss. It's more about chess, kind of setting people up to where they're in bad spots, being patient enough to where you honestly don't overcommit, but then you commit when the time is right and you know you can finish them with the amount of burst you have. How to take a fight in this game is something I had to learn, but now that you know that, you won't be surprised and you'll be able to do the actions according in order to actually have success. You know, I'm going to be honest with you, I felt that the pacing of this game was perfect. I actually really loved the early game, how fights lasted longer, I had more wiggle room to survive even though I wasn't able to kill people as easily, but I also at late game, because I was leveling up my abilities, leveling up my weapons, found that I was more lethal. I really did feel the impact of the leveling up process and the fusions that I was doing, and so I think that's going to reward you if you get fusions faster, if you get your teammates really calling out all the assault rifles they see, so you get that level 5 ripper maybe towards mid game, you're going to find a lot of kills off of that, and all these info tips on fights won't last, will last really long, they won't really matter because you'll be shredding people in no time. Number 8. The map. The map is a huge aspect of this game, and honestly, as a newer player, you may be surprised the map looks different every single time. That's because it does. The map auto-generates for every single game that you play, and it ends up creating different areas that are incentivized to land. Although those locations and what they are named seem to stay the same, it seems like their rotation or at least complementation for where they are amongst one another, as well as what the map and the surrounding areas allow you to play on, seem to shift as you play each game, making it a unique experience every time you jump in. And instead of a traditional ring, the map and the world around you will decay, like it's falling apart in front of your own eyes, forcing you into the next zone before you start taking damage and becoming an easy exposed target for your enemies. It's a pretty awesome take on what we usually see as a fog or a ring, and I think HYPERSCAPE has done a great job of not only keeping the game intense, but visually creating the element, not just behind you, but the world that you're in, as if it's falling apart, forcing you to be excited, or really I think more intent on moving into a place that hasn't started to decay yet. Some quick tips on this is that because it's auto-generated, have an idea of where you want to land, but be open to suggest change. Also, if you see an area that has like maybe one choke point leading from the island part of it to the mainland where you know the circle is going to end, maybe try to land someplace else, knowing that, hey, maybe we'll be good for this landing, but as it starts to decay, we'll only have one choke point where we can cross into the mainland, and that is going to screw us because of all the teams we'll have to fight and all the people who will already be there ahead of us. Number 9. How to master death. As we are so close to ending this video, I just want to say thanks for hanging out with me here, and hopefully you guys are enjoying this one, commenting down below what you think about it, and also leaving me a like if you enjoyed this video and you maybe want to see some more tips or some more gameplay on the channel. But moving into when you die, this is a really important tip, and I put it at number 9, so hopefully we would have something really interesting to talk about towards the end of the video. When you die, instead of going back into this spectating your teammate type thing that most battle royales do, you actually become a living playable thing where you use full movement controls, full jumping, called an echo. Echoes in HYPERSCAPE allow you to actually move your character, jump up like I was saying, like you would be alive, but the only difference is you cannot actually be seen by other living players, and you also cannot do any damage. But what you can do is what I'm here to talk about. An echo solves the issue of what do I do if I die? I'm bored, I want to start a new game instead of stay in this one, and it allows you to have a real good focus on retention for your player base. But more importantly, echoes can provide provide actual, valuable, and game-changing information to your teammates if you know what to do. The ping system still works as an echo, so it means that you could follow an enemy who might have gotten away from your teammate who's still alive and ping where they are, where they're hiding in a corner, whether they've jumped onto that next building, whether they're in a fight and it's a good time to third party. And because you have multiple echoes potentially on your team at a time, you could send your other teammate to do something else, like ping armor, ping weapons, ping a good area for you to sit out and maybe rat it to get to that top spot and fight for the crown. It's amazing because this tactical information is extremely powerful, and not only that, it's powerful because you have full mobility to get anywhere you want to use it. You're not limited like you are in Apex in a knocked down state. So take advantage of that and help your teammates that way. Another thing is echoes have a chance to be respawned after anybody has died on the map. When you die, they create this little beacon that you can jump into and press F on a keyboard to allow yourself to jump into this little triangle. When you actually have a teammate then jump in who is alive and press and hold F to revive you on that triangle while you're in it, you will be able to be revived fully back into the game, ready to go. There is no limit on how many times you can do this. There's also no limit on how many triangles there are. And whenever somebody dies, a new triangle will show up. So say you want to get both teammates back, you third party a good fight after they ping you where they are, and then ultimately you've got two deaths there, you respawn both your teammates, and you're back in the game. The only thing to remember is that at the restore points, which is what they're called, the echoes all see those restore points, and they're all trying to get back alive. So expect people to come through and try to get their teammates, and you may start fighting again and again and again because people keep trying to respawn their teammates where you have killed enemies. And finally, number 10, the crown. Unlike some of these games where you play in a battle royale and the last team standing wins, HYPERSCAPE actually gives you a new way to win the game, which is to collect the crown and keep it, almost as like a King of the Hill style moment. One of your teammates has to collect the crown, stand on it, grab it, and then hold it for about 45 seconds. If you can do this, you will win no matter how many teams are left standing. Pretty cool, and honestly, one of the ways I've won a game in HYPERSCAPE. So I encourage you to try it and understand that there are multiple ways to skin a cat. Not that we're skinning cats here on the channel, or anybody. I don't know why that saying exists. Who's skinning cats? Anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and you found something valuable. If you did, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. That helps me a lot and knows you want me to keep doing what I'm doing here. And if you want to play HYPERSCAPE, jump into my stream, twitch.tv/raindate right now, or, you know, if it's 2 days later, maybe not right now, and you'll be able to earn beta drops, which actually can get you into the game today, like right after you start watching. Pretty cool. So hopefully I see you guys there. As always, never give up, never stop gaming, and I'll see you all next time.